What is up, everyone? I am Demon Cringe, and today we're going to be talking about how Powerpuff Girls took on SJWs. And by the way, before we start, I'm going to be talking about the old one, so no, I'm not going insane. Now, isn't it just both ironic and sad how the new show basically became the 100% polar opposite of the original, especially with the premiere of the new girl, Bliss, who was basically just there to look a certain way? And we all know why, basically just becoming a typical one-dimensional character whose only characteristic is what's on the outside, unlike the original third Powerpuff Girl Bunny, who taught us all a valuable lesson, in that it's actually what's on the inside that counts instead of the outside. So for this video, I want to talk about two episodes in particular. Now, a lot of people might have probably forgotten about these, so let's get into it. Now, the first one I want to talk about is called Equal Fights, emphasis on the word equal, because it, of course, deals with radical third-wave feminists. Yes, everyone, our favorite fucking armpit hair dying warriors, oh boy. So the episode starts off with the girls obviously getting a call from the mayor in order to stop a bank robbery. They get there, and boom, we meet our new villain called Femme Fatale, whose entire character is basically she's a woman.
I wonder what kind of hulking ugly thug of a man is robbing the bank this time.
Whoa, man!
That's right, you sad excuse of a man. You've been rendered completely helpless by a woman, Femme Fatale. I'm the queen of corruption, the mistress of misdeeds, the dame of disaster. I'm gonna rob this burg blind, and there's nothing you macho meatheads can do about it.
And of course, she ends up stealing Susan B. Anthony coins and turning down the more valuable Ben Franklin ones because, of course, Ben Franklin is a man and she does not want anything to do with those.
What exactly do you think you're doing?
I'm putting the money in the bag.
Men can't do anything right! Who is this? Who is this? It's Ben Franklin, you idiot! A man! I want Susan B. Anthony coins. Now! That's better.
So here's where it takes a turn for the worst. They do end up capturing her, and while they are flying her to prison, Femme Fatale tries to convince them to let her go by basically trying to get under their skin by telling them things like there really aren't enough female superheroes as much as there are males. Typical, you know, how feminists in real life say that females are often underappreciated and blah 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 and all that. She also tells him that taking her to prison would be a negative blow to all of womankind, including them, and this is how they get you. They basically try to convince you into this whole imaginary us versus them mentality, and unfortunately it does actually work.
Come on, girls, think about what you're doing. Sending me to jail will be a blow for all of womankind, including you.
So in the middle of the episode, the girls are back at Pokyoke's kindergarten, and they have been turned into radical feminazis, resulting in them keeping a watchful eye on all the evil, conniving little boys conspiring to hurt the poor, defenseless little girls. By the way, before we continue, I really want to show you the last two clips of the episode, but unfortunately I kinda read that some users have been probably getting a copyright strike from showing them, so I'll just be narrating and showing pictures. So after that happens, they end up going to the mayor's office after Miss Bellum calls them. They are of course greeted by Miss Bellum and Miss Keen, who ask them why haven't they stopped Femme Fatale, and they give basically the typical feminist response, oh, it's the men that are responsible and blah blah blah, to which later they are greeted by three other women, the one on the left being just for comic relief, and the woman on the right says that Femme Fatale stole from her bank, and the security guard in the middle says that she got a broken arm because of her, and Miss Keen later tells them that the girls are in the city to protect the rights of everyone. So in the final part of the episode, they arrive at yet another bank robbery. Femme Fatale ends up telling them, hey, you've been doing a pretty good job kicking male butt and all that, and in reply the girls start schooling her about who Susan B. Anthony was. They tell her that during the time when women didn't have enough rights, that Susan B. Anthony broke the law by voting because she was a woman, and the court of course wanted to go easy on her because she was a woman, which she later demanded to be sent to jail just like any male criminal, and that is exactly where they were gonna to do to her. So finally they end up beating the crap out of her and sending her to jail just like she deserved. So what did this episode end up teaching us as kids? Well, it ended up teaching us that that people should be treated equally regardless of what they have between their legs. So the second episode I want to talk about is called Saving Mojo, and I really don't have a lot of clips to show, and I really don't have a lot to talk about this one because it is very straightforward, but it is pretty pertinent to the current political situation, and it basically predicts the future with the whole Tumblr SJW, you know, victim card pulling. The episode basically revolves around Mojo Jojo first committing a crime, getting beat up, and then being like, oh, I'm being oppressed and all that, and then a group of hippies rise to his defense, start arguing with the girls, and Mojo Jojo basically walking away scot-free, committing all the crimes that he wants.
There, there, little monkey dude.
I'm being oppressed!
This, of course, continues happening throughout the episode, but then at the end, the girls and the hippies come to an agreement, because since Mojo is a chimp, they decide to put him in a cage and send him to an island to live with his ape brethren and all that. And honestly, this is something that I've been thinking very much so. Now, of course, it is a joke, but I gotta say, it really would work, honestly. Like, can you imagine just rounding up all of the SJWs, putting them on some remote island so they can make each other's lives miserable while all the rational people are left in peace and all that? That would be absolutely perfect, because let's face it, political correctness and social justice are like basically like the modern versions of the Black Plague. Let's be honest, everyone, I'm not exaggerating, let's be fucking honest. Now, I gotta say, I just have huge amounts of respect for cartoonists that make stuff like this, because we need more of it. Like, in this day and age, we need more of that, because you know, you have the typical lessons in cartoons, such as, you know, share, you know, be nice and all that, blah blah blah. But sometimes we need a different kind of moral, you know, different kind of lessons to help kids grow mentally. And thankfully we are having a resurgence of that. Recently Gumball made an episode where Gumball became an SJW, and it was like really, really funny, you know, like addressing the hypocrisy and all that. I really didn't want to make a video on that, but unfortunately when it came out it kind of went over my head. But still, it's pretty awesome. Again, we need more intelligent cartoons like this. A lot of people might have probably forgotten about these episodes, but yeah, Powerpuff Girls did take on SJWs and they spanked them. They spanked them good. Well, everyone, that about wraps it up. Thank you so much for watching. Be sure to subscribe and press the little bell icon. And as always, I'm Demon Cringe, and I'll be seeing you guys and girls in the next video.